Good morning to you and welcome to the South Asian Army at Wisbech. We have some guests with us this morning who are new to Wisbech. I'd like to welcome Majors Fiona and Marty, and it's good to see our friend Gary with us from Peterborough. And to you at home watching this, you are very welcome, and we do hope that you enjoy this morning's special meeting. To my left, we have, of course, Major Martin Hill, and we also have someone you're going to be seeing quite a lot of this morning, as this really is his special meeting, and that is our dear friend and our new officer, Lieutenant Liam Beattie. You are very welcome for your first meeting. It's amazing. It was, I think, the 15th of March that we last had one here. So without further ado, we're going to move on to our first song. Now, we're not allowed to sing this morning, so it's very much up to you to sing out loudly on your comfy sofas this morning. So I'm just going to go and pop on the song. God bless you for joining us this morning, and enjoy this very special meeting. Thank you.
Let's pray together, shall we? Jesus, we thank you. We thank you so much for your grace, for your persistent love that draws us to you. And on this joyful morning for Wisbech Salvation Army, we just give you the thanks for all that you've done in this place in years gone past. God, we give you the glory for every person who's come to know you through the mission of these people. And Lord, as they start this new chapter, may your hand be upon this fellowship, and may the doors of heaven be open to this community. But God, we want to pray for Liam this morning. We thank you, Lord, for the journey he's had with you. We thank you, Lord, that he has discovered your grace, and that his determination to find you and to follow you and to receive your love will be the thing that drives his ministry in this place. Lord, we pray for this installation moment, that it will be a real anchor moment in his own faith journey, that will be something he looks back on as the moment when he began this chapter. But God, I want to pray for strength for him. I want to pray, Lord, that you will empower his spirit and his inmost being, that you will strengthen his soul, that you will give him wisdom beyond his years, and Lord, that you will give him courage to step forward in you and to bring others with him. May you make him a mighty leader of God's people. But Lord, make him a sharp missional tool in this town too. God, we pray that this building won't be the extent of his mission, but this town or the people that call Wisbech their home will come to know you as a result of the ministry of Wisbech Salvation Army led by Liam. So God, we're excited to see what comes next. So may you give us joy as we look back and we see all that you've done through this man of God in this place. Amen.
It's my privilege to welcome Liam on behalf of this Wisbech Corps. Circumstances have been unfortunate that not all of us are able to be present, but I'm sure there's people joining with us online and able to join in this celebration for the Corps remotely. However, hopefully someday soon we'll be able to gather together in person and we'll be able to meet you and everyone else be able to be able to meet them as well. As a call, we're very much looking forward to your arrival, although it's very short from finding out you were coming to us not being able to worship together. I for one am very grateful that someone has come. And I'd just like to take this opportunity to thank all the DHQ staff for their support during our period of unofficership, and in particular to Major Ian Mountford, who has now moved on, but I'm sure he's joining us online, and I thank him very much for his help and support over this last 12 months. It's been very helpful. Wisbech Corps is a small corps, but we're very friendly and a very family group, and we hope that you'll feel that as you start to meet people under the corps and get to know them. We are very grateful that you've come and that you've answered the call for officership and to come to be with us and that you've been appointed here. As you go forward, just be assured of all of our prayers and support in everything that you do for us, however that might progress in the next few months. Before we go to the installation service itself, I'm going to play a song called He Is Able, the words of which are, He is able, more than able, to accomplish what concerns me today. He is able, more than able, to handle anything that comes my way. He is able, more than able, to do much more than I could ever dream. He is able, more than able, to make me what he wants me to be. Please, those that are here, just look and think on the words, and for those at home, just to think about these words as we come to this special time. Thank you.
Pim, it's great to see you here in Wisbech. I want to join other people in welcoming you to this call and to leadership here. You've got a good group of supporters. You've got people in the congregation, your local officers and others, who I know will be a great support to you in so many ways. Not only is the court be looking forward to you coming here, but we at the divisional headquarters have been looking forward to you coming in. You've heard something about your enthusiasm, heard something about your desire to serve God and your love for Him. And I just get this sense that this could be a great time for God working in your life, in the life of this court, and also that this court, with yourself leading it, could have an impact in this town. So that's my personal welcome and welcome from all of DHQ. So it's lovely to be at this occasion this morning. What we're going to do, as happens in all occasions when an officer has taken up a new appointment, we have an official installation ceremony where the officer is invited to make certain promises. And I'm going to be inviting you to make those promises as we go through these next few moments. Just that reaffirm some of the important things about the ministry that you're going to be involved in and taking part in. And first of all, a Bible reading from Ephesians that speaks not only to Liam this morning, but also speaks to members of the congregation and all of us who share in the faith. Let's take it from Ephesians chapter 4, where Paul writes these words. I urge you then, I who am a prisoner because I serve the Lord, live a life that measures up to the standard God set when He called you. Be always humble, gentle, and patient. Show your love by being tolerant with one another. Do your best to preserve the unity which the Spirit gives by means of the peace that binds you together. Each one of us has received a special gift in proportion to what Christ has given. He did all this to prepare God's people for the work of Christian service, in order to build up the body of Christ. And so we shall all come together into that oneness in our faith and in our knowledge of the Son of God. We shall become mature people, reaching to the very height of Christ's full stature. Liam, Jesus said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of John, do you love me more than all these others do? Yes, Lord, he answered, you know that I love you. Jesus said to him, take care of my lambs. And pastoral care of your people. It's going to be so important. Think of pastoral care of the people you see before you here. Those who are members of the Corps, those who have some interest in the Corps, those who attend during the week. Your pastoral interest for them and beyond. So I charge you with the spiritual care of the men, women and children whose names are written on the walls of this Corps and those who are connected to this Corps. You are their shepherd. They look to you for spiritual guidance and care, and above all, to be their example. Be a shepherd of God's flock under your care, serving as an overseer. Liam, do you promise to be a true shepherd of the flock?
I promise.
The book of Proverbs says, he who wins souls is wise. You're standing there again by the mercy seat. We think of the significance of the mercy seat in the Salvation Army as a place where people come for prayer, but where people come for rededication, but also where to give their lives to God. So we recognize its significance there in the whole mission of the Salvation Army. I charge you to make all that's represented by this mercy seat the focal point of your ministry. Every task, however menial, should have as its motive the ultimate salvation of the souls of men and women. For this reason, you are appointed to the whole district with a charge to go for souls. You promise to direct your efforts to the saving of souls.
I promise.
Now I call your attention to the Salvation Army flag that's behind you there. And the truths that its colours represent. When you became a soldier of the Salvation Army, you clearly stated in signing your articles of war, believing that the Salvation Army has been raised up by God and is sustained and directed by Him, I do here declare that I am thoroughly convinced of the truth of the army's teaching. As you become a co-officer of this Beach Corps, I charge you to be loyal to God, also to the Salvation Army's principles, to uphold its standards and at all times to promote and support its interests. You promise to be true to all that our flag stands for.
I promise.
So next to you there on the table is the Bible, and you have in your hand your own Bible. We think of the centrality to all we do of the Word of God, how important it is for us personally, and our teaching and our preaching. In Hebrews we read the words, "The Word of God is living and active and sharper than any double-edged sword. You were appointed to be a minister of the Word. Into your care is entrusted the bread of life to pray for all." The pages of this book are words of comfort for the sorrowing, words of assurance for those whose faith falters, words of guidance for those who seek, and words of life who are dead in their sins. I charge you therefore before God, preach the word. Do you promise to preach and teach the word of God?
I promise.
Lieutenant Lee and Beattie, on behalf of the territorial commander, I receive your promises. And install you here as the court officer of Wisbech Corps. I'm sure not only my smile and your smile, but every smile of all the people watching this morning. I want to just remind you to determine to keep the promises you made today, allowing God to turn these moments of faith into months and years of grace. And I say to every member of this corps and every supporter of the Salvation Army in Wisbech, say to you, soldiers, adherents, congregation, volunteers, be loyal to God and proceed with continuing loyalty and support your new commanding officer, Lieutenant Liam Beattie. He's a good man. And we ask God a blessing upon him, the call, and the future ministry together. I'm going to say a prayer now for you, Liam. I'm going to invite everybody else to pray along this prayer as I say. Lord God, our Father, we thank you for the Church of Jesus Christ, for the apostles and all who through the centuries have kept the faith bright and shining. We thank you for the movement of your Holy Spirit and your call to costly discipleship and to increase your kingdom. We thank you for Lieutenant Liam as he stands here as a response to your call. Inspired by faith in you, empowered by your Holy Spirit, and supported by his congregation, may he be a means of leading many souls to faith in Jesus Christ. In the great task set before him, grant him spiritual wisdom, understanding, courage, and unfailing love in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Master. Amen. Now, Liam, as the new commanding officer of Wisbech Corps, I now invite you to come and to share the word of God.
Well, a very good morning to you here this morning and for those of you watching at home. As people have said already today, it's an unfortunate set of circumstances that we aren't able to meet in person for those who are watching at home. Nevertheless, the privilege is still mine to be moving here today and henceforth. And I count it a real blessing to be in a position here ministering to you in this way. And as we transition into sunnier times and into our lockdown, it is my personal prayer that we can do so together, embrace this next chapter together, and in the process, keeping the faith and unity that is said in Christ Jesus, as Paul's letter to the Ephesians says. And that's why this scripture this morning is so relevant, not only to myself in this calling of Salvation Army officership, but actually us as a church, as a community of Wisbech, we can embody these words according to the Church of Ephesus and embrace this next chapter together. Now at the time of writing this letter, Paul is in prison towards the end of his ministry and actually towards the end of his life. Paul was a man rich in wisdom and he emphasizes very crucial elements to the people of Ephesus. The body of the church and also the body of Christ through his people. He is saying that the church is not confined to four walls, that the church of Jesus Christ is its people, his people, those who belong to Jesus. That's us, friends, people who belong to Christ Jesus, of every race and every nation, who love Christ and are committed to serving him in whatever capacity. And even in these times of lockdown, in these times of not being able to meet together, those words still ring true, of still being the body of Christ and not confined to the four walls. We haven't been able to meet in together. What a blessing that is, to still be called the Church of Christ in these circumstances. Now, Paul talks about a unity, a grace of unity in the first three verses of this reading. And it's important to know that unity is not uniformity. Thank heavens for that. There is a challenge to the Ephesians to focus not on what divides them, but instead on what unites them. One body, one spirit, one hope, one God. We are united as children of God in this service, and we have a grace in that unity. And actually, as I transition into this new chapter of Wisbech, I kind of reflect on the one I've held from. And even so little as being in college has made me reflect on these things, and as I got to know my session mates, there's been a real joy in getting to know these people, not only at the cadets, but other officers in the Salvation Army. And I just think of our backgrounds as called people. I myself, before committing to the church full time, my trade was a high ropes instructor. So I used to do cliff climbing, abseiling, paddling. It was a totally different trade to the life of ministry now. But even as I got to know my sessions, some were dancers, some were at the DHQ, some were envoys. There was a whole catalogue of different richness and backgrounds to these people. And yet we were all still called by God under the same service of serving him. This may sound kind of odd, but there's beauty in that for me, to have all these different people united in that unity of serving Christ in this way. And that for me just made that chapter a little bit more richer. It made for a beautiful journey, actually. It really, really did. All united in our faith as children of God. And that is the same for Wisbech Salvation Army. Part of what makes me excited is getting to know people, getting to know you guys at home. And that same principle applies of being all united in fellowship together. Verse 3 says, make every effort to keep the unity of the Spirit. Unity which God produced through the reconciling death of Christ Jesus. He challenges us to keep that unity as a fellowship, as Wisbech Salvation Army, and even beyond in the vision. And there's a responsibility as called people to maintain that unity. But in verse 7, he also speaks of the gifts of unity and the vast differences of character and personality that we've already talked about. The psalmist in 139:14 says, we are uniquely, fearfully, and wonderfully made in the image of God, and all differently as well. Now, like we mentioned earlier, Paul shifts what we have in common in Christ and how we differ from one another, and actually what we do have in common together. As I read verse 7 again, it says, but to each one of us, grace has been given as Christ apportioned it. Grace has been given as Christ apportioned it. The grace through his fallen Son, Christ Jesus. And that not only goes for the grace that he offers us, but actually what he bestows upon us as children of God. What makes us all so uniquely and wonderfully made? What makes us all so unique as part of the fellowship and the church? I like to think of the spiritual gifts in that regard. Now, I have confession to make to you, friends. Before coming to Wisbech, I was actually pretty scared. It's a scary, scary thing. Because I thought to myself, I'm in this position now. I am the core officer. And I have to tell you, that scared me. It really did. It made me nervous. But God has blessed me with the people that I have encountered already through the people of this core, through the works of Paul and Adrian, Gary, anybody that I've met, people that have gifts that I surely don't. And And thank goodness for that. Thank God, hallelujah for that. That each one of us here in this room and beyond are part of that church and part of each other in the process. Our gifts, our abilities all differ from one another, even in this room. Yet Paul is suggesting that the gift of unity is utilizing that for God and each other. And this is what makes the church for me so beautiful, all these different people coming together in this unity, where Christ is glorified and that we are edified. And that's an exciting thing. And that's what makes me excited to meet all of you in the coming days. In Matthew's Gospel, Jesus had set a lofty charge to his disciples. He said, "Go and make disciples of all nations." To go and teach and preach and build and unify him. Such a lofty responsibility for these people. And that is something that we ourselves cannot be able to do. We are not able to do that by ourselves. We need that empowering from God, but actually we need that from each other as well as the church. Through this next chapter, through as we transition out of lockdown, it is my prayer, as I've said, that we are able to fulfill that charge as a church, as a community. And that excites me. The growth of unity is where God calls us as a member of his body, of his church, to fulfill the responsibility and actually journey together. And though I speak of Wisbech Salvation Army, it also does extend to the faithful DHQ team that are here this morning, that we're able to journey together. And actually, as I read the meeting plan, I was pleasantly surprised to see the song "He Is Able" that was included. Because actually that is what comes to mind, that he is able, more than able, to fulfill anything that comes my way. Through his spirit and through each other, he is able to have that growth of unity as the church. Paul was looking at this church in two ways. He saw the body of Christ and the body of true believers ministering to each other. And it is by ministering and working together that the church can express that fullness of Christ, what Christ represents. So friends, as we embark on this next journey together and transition out of lockdown, it is my prayer that we as Wisbech Salvation Army embody Paul's words as he does to the Ephesians, remembering his three G's of unity, the grace, the gifts, and the growth of unity. Growth in unity with each other and with Jesus. So crucial that it is with Jesus as well. To walk together as a unified body of Christ. Hallelujah! What a blessing that is. To walk as a body before him, on behalf of him, and say, this is who God has made us to be, and be that witness and message in our community. That is so exciting. What a privilege. As I say, hallelujah. For the record, I don't use that word very often, so it is a hearty thing. Under normal circumstances, we have been sharing in a song together. I dare to be different. I dare to believe. And obviously, those of us in this room this morning, we are not able to sing together, but we can still embody those words together and what that represents. That we do dare to be different, as the words say. I dare to live a life of faith, a life of challenge God has planned, of holiness and victory, for truth and righteousness stand. We dare to be different. We dare to believe. We dare to be that people for Christ, for the community. Because that is what we as a church and individuals are called to be for Christ. Unity with each other and unity with him. And as I say, what a blessing. Those of us in this room this morning, I just invite you just to absorb these words as the song is played. And for those watching at home, you're very welcome to sing along and actually testify to what these words mean. But as this song plays, let these words strike the truth of what we are called to be. as we embrace this next chapter together, transition out of lockdown, and excitedly say, this is what God has made us to be. Thank you, Adrian, in which we will share in benediction. Spirit. Amen. Amen. Friends who are watching at home, I look forward to getting to know you in the coming days. Until then, everybody, be blessed, be a blessing, and may God bless you all. Thank you.
When I am down and oh my soul, trouble comes.
Thank you.